invisible. Now, actually, you look at many games, actually we set limits. You know, we jump over, you know, if you are talking about high jump, you actually jump over a certain height. Now, so there are various types of limits, and then you have landing limits, you have you know, the margin, all sorts of limits. Those invisible limits, like individual limits, mental limits, psychological limits, energy limits, market limits, and time limits. Now, so when we talk about limits, actually it is a big challenge. Let me try to define limit. Now, this is actually a mathematical definition of a limit. The technique used is called category theory. Now, the category theory was invented, was actually accidentally discovered in 1941 through 1945 by the Samuel Eilenberg and Saunders McLean. And those days it was called theory of equivalence. Now, why they discovered this technique? It was because by 1941, mathematical proofs are getting extremely long. Some of the mathematical proofs actually go on for hundreds of pages. And to the extent that mathematical colleagues cannot counter-proof or verify proofs that are written by other mathematicians. Now, so McLean and Eilenberg thought that, why not we do this? Why not we find out which are the portion of proofs that can be established in this way? And you can see that the advantage of this is that you have one proof, two proof, three proof, four proofs, and maybe here is 200 proofs. And because they can be figured out this way, and when it can be figured out this way, is considered valid. Now, so actually that way you verify proofs in very fast way, extremely fast, and you can abbreviate them into one big arrow from here to there. So, well, it was meant to shorten proofs, but then there were a lot of disagreement. So from 1941 to 1960, this technique was called by most mathematicians theory of nonsense. Okay, now it took 20-something years for mathematicians from all walks of fields to work together actually to ascertain that this method is actually valid. And today it's called category theory, actually in remembrance of Aristotle, who actually started not only logic, but another branch called category. Most of scientists, economists, and mathematician has given up on category, except in the field of laws. And that's why in law, you have this word, a category today is a legal term.